Hi everyone, welcome to this Twinmotion 2020 tutorial series. In this one we are going to have an in-depth look at the presenter tools that we have inside Twinmotion. So first off, what is a presenter? A presenter is a standalone viewer that doesn't require Twinmotion to run. With it, you can basically create a virtual visit of your project and you can share it with your client. You can just launch the application and navigate through the project or just follow the presentation you have set up. To create a presenter, you need to go to the media section inside Twinmotion. And this is the fourth media that you can export. Before starting with the presenter, you need to have other media set up. So in this specific project, if I come to the image doc, I've already created some images, like I have here. I also have created a few videos. So now let's go to the presenter doc. To create my first presenter, I will click on the big plus button, Create Presenter. Once I am inside my presenter number one, I can now start to add some media into this specific presenter. So I just click on this button here, it will open the list of media present in my project. To add a media, it's just basic drag and drop from the list here to the bottom over here. So I just start with my site view, which is the aerial view I'm in over here. In this specific image, I've set up the camera position and I also added some notes that you may have seen in a previous tutorial. I can keep adding a few images. So let's now switch, for example, to the project view, which is a closer view at the project, like here. Then we have a view where the user will arrive to the project from the road. Then we have a view to the lobby from the parking. So here I'm in the parking and I can start to see the lobby of my hotel. So the project is an hotel in the middle of a forest near Vancouver. So after this lobby view, I've created a video that will guide the user, that will guide my clients from the parking to the lobby. So this is this video over here, parking to lobby. So I'm just going to place this video over here. So as you can see here, you have a small icon that tells you what kind of media this is. So this is an image, it won't be moving, but this is a video. So if I mouse over, I can see, I can visualize my video. So here I'm just basically creating my presentation, creating the experience my viewer will see when they will launch this application. So I have a few other videos to add. So after the parking to lobby, we have the lobby to dining room video. Then I have a small time lapse at the end, just with the sun going down like that. And to finish, I have a few other images, like we have, for example, the terrace view, we have lobby project. And to finish, I have also a view with technical stuff like all my MEP that you may have already saw in another tutorial as well. By the way, here I have two times the same image, but one with the MEP and one without. I'm just going to click on the three button here to set this image as an alternative. That means that when I will be presenting this project, when I will follow the presentation, at some point I will be able to see this point of view from this view here without the technical stuff, and I will be able to switch to the other presentation of this same point of view with the technical stuff, with all the MEP present. So here I have set up my whole presentation. It contains some images, it contains some video, it can also contain some panorama, it will work the same way as an image. Here I have an image as an alternative. Now if I want to visualize that, I can have a preview directly from Twinmotion. I don't need to export a standalone application to visualize that. So I can click over here on the I button, and here we have the presenter mode and the shortcut is F12. When I click on that, I will switch full screen in the presenter UI. In this UI, it's pretty basic. You have just a play button where you will follow the presentation. Here this button will allow you to hide and show the UI. And here at the top of the screen, we have a few options, like here, changing the time of day, for example, or changing the speed to navigate inside the viewport. So let's just hit the play button and see how it works. So as you can see here at the bottom, we have a small timeline that is advancing. For each image that you have in your presenter, it will last 5 seconds. Here at the end of this image, I will switch to my video. And this is really the presentation I have set up inside Twinmotion. It's just a way to present my project. So I can just follow the presentation, but at any moment I can also pause, I can switch from different slide. And here on the last slide, I have my alternative view. Here you can visualize that by the small icon that you have on top of the image. So if I arrive on this image, we have this end icon, and if I click on this icon, I can visualize the same point of view but with my MEP. So it's an alternative view of the same point of view. So this is just a quick look at the presenter UI. Now let's exit that and let's check how you can export this file. To export a presenter, I will simply go to the export doc. Here you have the option presenter, by default it's off. If I just turn this option on, now I can start to export it. Actually, before I export my presenter, let's come back in our media. I will come back here in my breadcrumb and enter the settings of this specific presenter. Here we have two options. The first one is the media framing. It's the black line, the black box that you have on each side of your presenter. If you have set up different camera with different ratio, you can enable that or leave it by default. The second option is the camera movement. You can, by default, when you export a presenter, it will be in free mode. That means that at any moment during the presentation, your user, your viewer, will be able to play the animation you have set up, but pause it, turn the head around, and also move inside your project. In ride mode, your viewer will only be able to play the camera, pause, and turn the head around. They won't be able to navigate inside the project. Finally, in the locked state, your user will only be able to play the animation you have set up. They won't be able to turn the head around or navigate. So now that's done, let's come back to the export doc. In the more here we have an option that allows you to select the presenter you want to have inside your file, so you can have multiple presenter and export them all at once. So let's come back to the presenter now and start to export it. I will send that to my desktop. Now that's done, let's check my desktop. Just going go over here. And here, as you can see, on my desktop, I have this new folder that just has been created. On PC, it will create a .exe file, while on Mac, it will create a .app. If I open my folder, here I have the presenter, and here I have all the files that need to stay together with the .exe file. So if you want to share this, we suggest zipping this file over here and sending all the content together. Now if I want to launch my application, I will just double click on my .exe file. The first screen that appears when you launch the application is this one. There is a few information regarding the navigation with a keyboard and mouse, but you can also use a touchscreen to navigate inside that. And then we have also some other information like the gamepad control and other third-party stuff. And now this is the same presentation as I've set up inside Twinmotion. I can play, I can pause at any moment, I can switch from the different slide, I can collapse my UI and open it back. And here up here we can also change the time of day if I want. And of course, for example here, when my camera is moving, since I've exported this presentation in free mode, at any moment I can turn the head around while my camera is advancing, and I can also pause and start navigating inside my project. And that's it for this quick presentation of the presenter. Hope you guys enjoy. See you for the next one.